And God, we look to you tonight. Above the singing, God, above the music, above the songs, let your name be lifted high, Jesus. Let your name be honored, God. And we commit all that we are to you, God, everything that we do, and we reach towards you.
Surrender. Praise the Lord. Good morning to everyone. Seeing then that we don't have a packed audience, could I ask the folks who are sitting way in the back there, could you come a little closer, please? Let's occupy the seats in front here. Hallelujah. On the behalf of Reverend Alistair Alexander and the entire Daybreak family, we want to extend our condolences to the family of the deceased, and we pray at this time God's grace, which is ever sufficient, and his strength will be made perfect in your time of weakness, in your hour of bereavement. I want to ask us to stand at this time, please, as we officially open in a word of prayer. Now, I know this is an occasion, there is an element of sadness and bereavement, but this is still the day that the Lord has made. Amen? Can somebody say praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
Do we have any worshipers here this morning?
Amen.
Do we have anybody here that love Jesus?
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Come on, could we just lift our hands?
Hallelujah.
Come on, just could we just take 2 minutes without any music?
God.
Nobody prompting you. Come on, just lift your voice and give him praise. Father, we bless you. In everything, we give you thanks. The psalmist David declared, I will bless the Lord sometimes. No, he said, I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. Come on, somebody help me praise him. Somebody help me lift up our King. Father, we worship you. We don't give him some of the praise. We give him all the praise, all the glory. We magnify your name. Come on. Come on, let there be an exchange. Let there be a divine exchange in this house. Oh God, we put on, we take off the spirit of heaviness and we put on the garment of praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Bible declare what? The fruit of our lips giving thanks unto the Lord. Come on, somebody, open your mouth and give him praise. Family, Lambkin family, come on, open your mouth and give him praise. Hallelujah. Let your praises, as the song says, let praises rise from the inside. Father, we bless you. Father, you are still faithful. You are still true. You are still righteous. You are still holy. You are still awesome. Hallelujah. And we reverence you. We bless your name. Come on, one more minute. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We welcome the presence of the Holy Spirit in this house. Hallelujah. Give beauty for ashes. Give gladness for mourning. Give strength for weakness. Yea, we bless your name. We worship. We praise. We break our alabaster box this morning and we pour out our praises as a sweet perfume. Let the aroma of our worship and our praise fill this house. Let your Shekinah glory come down in this place. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, just praise him now. We praise you. We say like the psalmist, we bring the sacrifice of praise into the house of the Lord. Hallelujah. Did you walk with your praise this morning? Did you? Oh, come on, we bring the praise. We bring the praise this morning. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Blessed be the rock of my salvation. For he is my rock, he is my defense, he is my refuge, he is my strength, he is my strong tower, he is my shepherd, hallelujah, he is my light, hallelujah, he is my life. So God, we bless you and we praise you, we give you all glory, all adoration, we adore you. Come, let us worship and bow down, let us kneel before the Lord God, our maker, for he is our God, and we reverence you. We reverence you in this house this morning. We bless your name. We bless your name. We worship. We worship you. We praise you. We extol you, God, above all else.
We welcome your presence. We welcome you. Ah, God. Welcome, Holy Spirit. We are in your presence. Fill us with your power. Sweet Holy Spirit. Ah, God. Sweet Holy Spirit. Sweet Holy Spirit. Ariabashandi, God, we bless your name. Welcome, 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 Holy Spirit, in this house. We worship you. We bless your name. We bless your name. Father, we thank you, Lord. We thank you for everything that will be said and done in this house. We thank you, Lord, for your presence here in our midst. For your word tells us that you will never leave us nor forsake us. So we thank you for your presence. We thank you for the comforting presence. Yes. You are the God of all comfort. So God, we do bless you and we give you praise. May everything that will be done here have your stamp of approval. May you be well pleased. May you choose the tabernacle in our midst here this morning, oh God. So Father, we give you all the glory and all the praise. Come on, somebody, put your hands together for Jesus. Put your hands together for the King. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Now maybe you're asking yourself, why do we clap? Do you know what you're saying when you're clapping like that? When you clap like that, what we are actually saying is well done.
Amen.
Bravo. Yes. Well done, Jesus. So now that you have the understanding and you know what you're doing, I want you to put your hands together and say, well done, Jesus. Well done, and we appreciate. Bravo. Bravo to the King. Hallelujah. As I welcome our worship leaders who will lead us in time of worship.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the name of Jesus. He is good and his mercy endureth forever. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Well, good morning, everyone. And our condolences goes out to the family. We pray that the Lord will strengthen you and comfort at this time. Praise the Lord. The songwriter said, it is well with my soul. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We give you praise, God. We give you glory. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. When peace like a river tended my way, when sorrow like sea billows roll, whatever my Lord thou hast taught me to say, it is well with my soul.
blessed of his glorious storm. My sin not in part, but the whole. It is nailed to the cross, and I bear it no more. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, oh my soul. Oh, it is well with my soul.
Salvation, which is so free and rich. Ah, hallelujah. We give you praise. We give you praise, God. Hallelujah. Lord, we your people, oh God, stand in your presence and give you praise. We praise your name. We praise you, God. Hallelujah. That we can stand and say, it is well. It is well with my soul. Hallelujah. How great thou art. Hallelujah. How great thou art. Hallelujah. Oh Lord, my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the stars. put your hands together for a great God. Hallelujah, a great and mighty God. He is great. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. You may have your seats at this time. Blessed be the name of the Lord. At this time, we have a tribute coming from Royston. John, could you come at this time? Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
I am still baffled as to the thought of being asked to give a tribute to this man. I was like, why me? I didn't even know this guy. So immediately I Googled it. What is a tribute? And Google says, Google is always right. Google says, a tribute is a commemorative speech that allows you to share your love, respect, and admiration to your loved one. I was asked how to do this a few days ago, so please forgive me if I stutter or speak some amazing things. Greetings in the wonderful name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior. Blessed morning to the congregation. A tribute to a friend. Some knew him as Gramphy. Some knew him as Mr. Lambkin. Some knew him as Mr. Sid, short for Mr. Sidney. And as I recently found out, attending Mrs. Louisa's funeral, a guy walked up to me and he said to me, boy, you walking with Thor? So someone knew him as Thor as well. But to me, I took it as a legend. He was always a legend. On the other hand, I call him, when I walk to his gate, I call him amigo. And the first thing he will say is, que pasa? We would laugh. For so long, in sincerity, for so long, I imagine giving him this tribute, but not a tribute, but saying something like this, not knowing how to word it. But I was hoping it never came. Most of the times I saw him, I'd say, bless the Lord, O my soul. And he had finished my saying by saying, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. I think somewhere along the line, he just wanted someone to tell all his old stories. Two, plus latest bacchanal, whether from the news or from in the village or from his neighbors. And don't forget the witty jokes. And I would laugh wholeheartedly because I myself saw him as a father figure. We would have many escapades throughout the years, Price Mart being one of them. And about 6 weeks ago, we went to Price Mart. So when we walking into Price Mart, I said to him, you see that kind of, the trolley kind of thing, you could drive in that, boy. He said, boy, you feel like it's a cripple hour. When we reach in Price Mart and we walking down the aisle, somebody say, Lambkin, Lambkin. He could not recognize who the person was. But when he did recognize, he retired 15 years prior to the guy, but the guy was in the same trolley. You see, there is old people by. And we continued along, you know. I took him to the beach on his birthday, as I would usually do on many times, we'd often do. And I put on Maria by Lord Blakey. Well, he sang his belly out. He said, if you think it easy to take Gramphy money, well, you know the rest. We sang, and then I put on, it was his birthday, so I put on Frank Sinatra, I did it my way. And in all fairness, I never saw Gramphy so joyful. He sang Frank Sinatra. I did it my way from the top to the bottom. And that is how the guy was. He did it his way. That is Frank Sinatra in the black image. You know, so we talk, he could nam Mr. Lambkin, or I will call him Lumskin. Mr. Lumskin couldn't walk well. Many times we go to the marketplace, and if Roger will say, hey, where Grandfee? Where Grandfee? He's still walking. But when he go in the water, man, he's swimming like a fish. That is Grandfee. You know, a couple of days before he passed, we would have I'd visited him Sunday, and I said to him, I said, well, we're going horsey funeral. Who is our neighbor? We're going horsey funeral tomorrow. But before that, I think like the Tuesday, the weekend, I called him, I said, Grandfee, boy, I hear horsey kick the bucket. He said, boy, what are you really telling me? Oh, horsey can kick the bucket and horsey at 1 foot. So he lied and kick the bucket then. We laugh. So when I went and check him this Sunday, I said, we going horsey funeral him now. I really ain't feeling up to it. And he said, I wouldn't go that one. I said, okay. So when I get him ready the Monday morning to come outside, I see him stand up by the car, waiting to go in the front seat. I said, that is his spot. I said, Grandfee, what are you doing here? I thought you're not going anywhere. He said, boy, everything people tell you, just believe. I said, Grandfee, well, you can't blame me if I believe in you. Hear me now. Proper talk, proper talk. And we move on. Grandfee's life was a life that was full of God's grace, mercy, and favor followed him. Because he always had a good heart. So he lived a peaceful life. I think that stood out to me, the peace. So I say, cheers to a legend. In closing, if I ask anyone who is in the congregation or in the pews now, if I ask you, do you think you're going to live forever? Most of you might say no. But if I ask you, do you think that you would die tomorrow? Most of you would hope not. Tomorrow is promised to no one, beloved. But your tomorrow could very well be today. Don't take no chances. Give yourself a fighting chance by making your election sure. We will not always be as fortunate as Mr. Lumskin to make it to 89 out of 89, but it's a massive, mighty score. So let us do what we could do to make it right with Christ. Don't leave today if you have a decision to make. It could be personal or outward, and make a decision that you want to turn your life around, give your life to Christ. Because with Christ, you have a winning coach on your side. He died at 89 years old and left no debt outstanding. That is the most amazing thing. So, in closing, what I took from him, Mr. Lambkin always spoke about family. And I think that way we are gel to him. He always spoke about his children, memories from Vinciland, and working in the port, working in City Corporation. So Mr. Lambkin was a good example, and let us not let his legacy pass us by without taking something from it. This is my 2 cents.
Praise the Lord. Amen. A man who lived to be 89, and according to our speaker, you might be young today, you don't know if you might get old. That is the reality of life. At this time, we have the eulogy coming from Mary Lambkin Lewis. Could you come at this time, please?
Good morning, and thank everyone for attending. A famous writer once said, we make a living by what we get. We make a life by what we give. If that is true, then our beloved Sidney Lambkin made a great life. Sidney Lambkin, better known as Grandfee, or Daddy as we called him, was the most generous person I know. I am extremely grateful for the time we shared during his time here. Sidney Donaldson Lambkin was born February 7, 1935 in Rose Hall, St. Vincent. He was the second of 17 siblings to Alva Lambkin and the eldest of 9 born to Isabel James, a total of 28 siblings. Sidney was very ambitious at a young age. He attended school in the Isle of St. Vincent and at the age of 17, boarded a boat to Trinidad. In Trinidad, Sidney worked diligently as a laborer. Shortly after, his love for cars guided him to an auto mechanic shop in St. James. Daddy's ambition and benevolence landed him a job as an oiler for the City Council Corporation. There he worked until his retirement, as he skillfully ensured the tractors and trucks were maintained. At the age of 23, Daddy began thinking of love. He met a beautiful young lady called Patricia Gordon and made a very responsible decision to marry this lovely lady. They had 5 beautiful children, Claudia, Chris, and Peter, deceased, and Tony and myself, Mary. We were loved and cherished in our home. Daddy was a man of many skills. He was a very charismatic and quick-witted, and even a comedian. You were bound to laugh and roll once in his presence. Daddy enjoyed reaching for higher heights. One of his favorite things to do was climbing to the top of the house to relax. There he enjoyed the cool breeze and, yes, even fell asleep. Daddy also loved to spend time reading the Bible, and you would always hear him whistling his favorite tunes. Some of you know him as Sidney, Mr. Lambkin, or Grampy, given by his grands. We are here today because of the impact he made on our lives. It is a difficult time. It is important to remember good memories we made with him. He lived a good and fulfilled life. He served God with his whole heart. It's really hard to say goodbye to someone who has been there for us our entire lives. Our ups and downs, good and indifferent. So we would enjoy our time walking on the streets of gold and taking heavenly breeze on your mansion rooftop till we meet again. A tribute to how we ended each conversation. Bye, Daddy, I love you. Then Dad will say, bye, my one and only, I love you more. Thank you.
At this time, we have a special song by the grandchildren. Could you all come at this time, please?
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
So, one of the songs that we are going to sing is a song Love by Grampy. Everyone's supposed to know the song, so y'all can join with us as we, and, you know, as we try to sing. Yeah. Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not, thy compassions they fail not. As thou hast been, thou forever will be.
Yes, Lord.
Faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness, morning by
song.
Hallelujah. Come on, could we put our hands together one more time for the grandchildren? Great is thy faithfulness. Could you all stand with me one more time for the reading of the word of God? And I know many of us, we have our Bibles and our devices. I'm reading from the King James Version, Matthew's Gospel, chapter 25. And we want to do a bit of reading this morning. Matthew's Gospel, chapter 25, and reading from verse 14. For the kingdom of heaven is as a man traveling into a far country, who called his own servants and delivered unto them his goods. And unto one he gave 5 talents, and to the other, and to another 2, and to another 1. To every man according to his several ability, and straightway took his journey. Then he that had received the 5 talents went and traded with the same, and made them other 5 talents. And likewise he that had received 2, he also gained other 2. But he that had received 1 went and digged in the earth and hid his Lord's money. And after a long time, the Lord of those servants cometh and reckoneth with them. And so he that had received 5 talents came and brought other 5 talents, saying, Lord, thou hast delivered unto me 5 talents. Behold, I have gained beside them 5 talents more. His Lord said unto him, well done, thou good and faithful servant. Thou hast been faithful over a few things. I will make thee ruler over many things. Enter thou into the joy of the Lord. He also that had received 2 talents came and said, Lord, thou deliverest unto me 2 talents. Behold, I have gained 2 other talents beside them. His Lord said unto him, well done, good and faithful servant. Thou hast been faithful over a few things. I will make thee ruler over many things. Enter thou into the joy of thy Lord. Then he which had received the 1 talent came and said, Lord, I knew that thou art a hard man, reaping where thou hast not sown, and gathering where thou hast not strawed. And I was afraid, and I went and hid my talent in the earth. Lo, here thou hast that is thine. And the Lord said unto him, thou wicked and slothful servant, thou knewest that I reap where I sowed not, and gather where I have not strawed. Thou oughtest therefore to have put my money to the exchangers, and then at my coming I will have received my own with usury. Take therefore the talent from him, and give it unto him that had 10 talents. For unto every one that had shall be given, and he shall have abundance. But from him that had not shall be taken away even that which he had. And cast ye the unprofitable servant into outer darkness, where there shall be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Father, we bless your name. We thank you for your word. And Jesus, you declare that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. The grass withereth, the flower fadeth, but the word of our God shall endure forever. Wherewithal shall a young man cleanse his ways, but by taking heed to your word. Your word is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our pathway. We ask, Lord, that you will illuminate our hearts, illuminate our pathways, Oh God, we turn on the light, revelation knowledge, illumination knowledge. We declare, let there be light in this house, God. May somebody, oh God, come out of darkness this morning and this service. In Christ's name, amen and amen. You may be seated. If I should give this passage a theme, I would like to simply call it wise investment. Wise investment. It is very, very important that as individuals that we make sure that the investment that we make in this life is an investment that will last for all eternity. We are a pilgrim people. And what I mean by that is that we will not be here forever. We are all on a journey. And I know it is one thing to read in the papers and to hear in the news concerning people dying all over the world, right here in our beloved nation. Now, death is not something strange. Death is not something new. Death has always been with us from the very beginning of time. But when it comes home and it is a loved one, a dad, a mom, a close friend, a relative, it brings a different sting. And I'm saying to all of us, the question is, what kind of investment are you making? Because what we put in is what we will get out. Now, when we look at this passage that is before us, Jesus speaks this parable. And the parable is what we might consider to be an earthly story, or as it were, that carries with it a heavenly message. And the message is about investment, how we invest our lives, how we invest our time, because the talent represents our ability, it represents our time, it represents our resources, and it also represents our opportunity to serve God on earth. Because there is a day coming, now mind you, I'm not preaching to Mr. Lambkin. I'm preaching to us who are here. His leg of the race is over. Because there is coming a day in which every individual that is listening to me here in this congregation, and for those who probably are viewing by the social media, we will all stand before God. Revelation, which is the final book of the Bible, John the Revelator, he said, I saw the dead, I saw the rich, I saw the poor, I saw the large, and those who have gone on before. He said, I saw them, they were all standing before God. And I want you to pause and think about that for a moment. There is a day coming in which we will all stand before God, and to me that is very, very sobering. We will not stand before God based upon our religious persuasions. We will not stand before God with your group and your family members, or as the young people say, your boys and your dogs and your homeboys. We will stand before God individually. That is a sobering thought. And here we see, as I said, from the text, and there are four things I would like to draw from this text in terms of our investment. And I want to use the letter R to bring out my 4 points. Jesus said, for the kingdom of heaven is as a man that is traveling into a far country. And a call was made, first of all, a call was made to the servants. An invitation was extended. And just as in this service this morning, an invitation is extended to all of us here to get involved, to participate. Kingdom involvement. Kingdom investment. So the master, he called his servants, and the scripture said he distributed his talents to his servants. 5, 2, 1. So the first R I want to draw from this text is the word received. Each of the servants, they received something from the master. In other words, your ability, your gifting, your skill, your resources, and even your time has been given to you by Almighty God. How are you using your time? How are you using your resources? And the thing about time, every person here, we have 24 hours per day. You cannot say, brother, you will use 14 and carry across 10 for tomorrow, next day. No. We all have the same allotted time every single day. So he called the servants and they received, each of them received different giftings. 5, 2, 1. And the Bible said, after a while, the master, he took his journey into a far country. In other words, each individual had time to invest. The question to every person here, how are you investing? What kind of investment are you making when it comes to the kingdom of God? Because it's only our investment in the kingdom of God will last for all eternity. We know the old song. Only one life. And only what we do for Christ will last. The Bible said, after the distribution and they all received their different talents. No, I want you to look at something here. Each servant they received, there was an unequal distribution. 5, 2, 1. Now the question we may ask ourselves, why was there an uneven distribution? How come everybody didn't get 5? How come everybody didn't get 2? And how come everybody didn't get 1? You see, God knows what you could handle. God knows what you could handle, sister. As the old saying goes, God will not give you more than you can bear. But I have a little different slant to that, because I believe God sometimes will give you more than you can bear, but he will help you to carry it. But in this context, everybody, there was an uneven distribution. He know what your capability, he know what you can do, Tony. He knows your strength. He knows your weaknesses. He know what you can handle. So nobody have a right to watch one another and say, well, how come she get 5 and I only get 2 and I only get 1? No. And after the master took a journey into a far country, they went out there and invest. The one who got 5, he went and invested and he gained another 5. The one who got 2 went and invested and he came back with another 2. Now my second R, apart from based upon received, is the word reckoning. There is a day of reckoning. The word reckon is an accounting term. In other words, there is a day of accountability. That we will have to give an account, and I don't know about you, but this is sobering to me as a preacher, because when I stand before God, it will not be about the Pentecostal assemblies of the West Indies. And all of us, we are laboring to hear a simple phrase. Well done. Well done. Not well done, apostle. Not well done, bishop. Not well done, evangelist. But what? Well done, thou good and faithful servant. Not well done, apostle, well done, servant. This is why we live, we want to hear at the final day, well done, well done, well done. There's a day of reckoning, ladies and gentlemen, that we will have to give an account. The Bible said, it's the third hour is return. The scripture said the master took a journey, but keep in mind the master is returning. Are you with me? According to our brother Jaron, are making sense?
The master is returning, and there will be a day of reckoning. The scripture said the master, he called his servants now, and he wanted them to give an account. And the scripture said the one who received five, he came and he said, "Master, you gave me five. I have traded and looked the interest. Five more. Well done, thou good and faithful servant." The one that got the two, he came. He said, "Master, you gave me two. I went and I traded. Look again, another two." In other words, your life must bring forth some sort of profit. Your life has to have some benefit, some significance. And I want to let you know, significance in life does not begin with money. Significance begins with God. Purpose begins with God. You see this microphone don't know its purpose. I have to ask the person who created this microphone. Your cell phone don't know its purpose. The person who created the cell phone, the person who created you. So purpose begins with God. And could I say this, please, ladies and gentlemen, God is not your appendix. Eh? You could cut out your appendix and still live in it. But God is not your appendix. With him, without him, we cannot survive. The day of reckoning, the master is returning. Five, two, one. I wonder how many you may have in your hand. We may have some people here who have five. Somebody may have two. But look at the guy with the one. And this is the guy we want to focus on, because I feel some of us sometimes we could find ourselves in this category. Because every person listening to me here and those who are viewing, you will find yourself in either one of these three categories. Five, two, or one. The scripture said the guy who received the one, he was afraid. And instead of using what the master gave, instead of investing himself, his talent, the Bible said he went and he hid it. In other words, this man, he decided to play it safe. Tony, how many of us, it's not about playing it safe, you know. It's use it or lose it. Could I say this to all of us? Use it, sister, or lose it. It's not about playing it safe. He decided, well, I'm going to dig a hole. I'm going to bury my talent. I'm going to keep it safe and shiny and new. So when the master came and there was that day of reckoning, probably he brought it back and he said, "Master, you see the same way you give it to me? Look, I'm bringing it back the same way. I ain't touch it. I ain't scratch it. I ain't do anything about it. It's shiny and new brand." Now keep in mind, every person, the five and the two, they receive the same acclamation. Well done, well done. Thou good and faithful servant, thou hast been faithful over a few things. You recognize they were promoted. So promotion comes as a result of faithful service. The guy with the one, he said, "Master, I know you're a hard man. Master, I know you're dreading. Just reap where you didn't sow and all of that." So I decide to play it safe. I wonder, we may have some people here in that category, you're playing it safe. How many of us know in this life, there are times, sometimes you have to be willing to take a risk. You have to make a kingdom investment, my investment in the kingdom of God. Because this is where the Bible put it this way. He said, where a man's treasure is, there will be his heart. The question to all of us, where is your treasure? Where are you laying up your treasure? Is it that you're just living just for now? And you see me, I'm just caught up with just this life. I want to let you know there's a new day coming. Eh? There's a new day. He brought his one and he said, "Master, look, the one that you gave me. No profit. I didn't do anything with it." And look what the master said to him. He said, "Thou wicked and slothful servant." Now that is a hard thing, eh? You're wicked and you're lazy. That is a dread combination. And it's one thing to be wicked, but to be wicked and lazy too. "Thou wicked and lazy servant, slothful servant." There is a day of reckoning, but there is also a day of reward. That is my final hour. What we have received, the master, the day of reckoning, the master is returning, and there is a day of reward. We will be rewarded. Keep that in mind. Look at the Apostle Paul at the end of his earthly sojourn. Oh, hallelujah. Paul says, what? I have fought a good fight. I have kept the faith, and I know there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the righteous judge shall give me on that day. Every person here must live with this concept in mind. There is a that day experience for every person in this house. And that has nothing to do with religion. That has nothing to do with religious denomination, because we may pride ourselves. Well, I belong to this religion. I was born in this and I will die with this. Make sure you die with Jesus, eh? Because there is a that day. Paul understood that. With all that he went through, he was shipwrecked. He was placed in prison. He was beaten. He was lowered from a basket over a wall. All that he encountered from the road of Damascus, where he had an encounter with Jesus. Every persecution, every trial, everything that he faced in life. He was bitten on an island by a serpent. He shook it off. Revival broke out. He's in prison. He kept in mind, that day, I will stand before my God. That day. Read the book of Revelation. John the Revelator, he said, I saw every man standing before God, and the books were open, and another book was open, and every man was judged according to which school he went to, according to his religion, according whether his father was the pastor and grew up in church. No, every man was judged according to his deeds. He was judged according to that which is written. Selah. Pause and think about it. It is saying our lives are documented. Your life, your thoughts, every action, every move you take is being recorded. And I want to let you know, when you stand before the judge of the whole earth, there will be no privy council. There'll be no court of appeal. He's the just judge. His verdict is final. We sing the song in church. Who has the final say? Jehovah. How am I investing my life? Am I making a wise investment? And according to Bishop Alex Alexander, if you're not wise, then you're otherwise, you know. Could I say that? If you're not wise, then you're otherwise. The guy who received the one, he was otherwise. Use it or lose it, sister. Thou lazy, thou slothful, wicked and slothful servant. And he lost what he had, and it was given to someone else. And the scripture said they bind him and they cast him out into utter darkness, where there was weeping and gnashing of teeth. Ultimate rejection. Keep it in mind, brethren. The ultimate rejection. Jesus put it this way. The Beatitude in Matthew's Gospel, chapter 7, which I consider to be the most sobering passage of scripture in the Bible. When Jesus said to his disciples, he said, not everybody who say, Lord, Lord. I don't know about you, I consider this to be the most sobering passage in the Bible. He said to them, he said, not everybody who says, Lord, Lord, will enter the kingdom. He that doeth the will of my Father. No question to all of us. How are you in terms of your investment? Are you doing his will? Or are you just simply existing? Pastor hearing you, know, but I don't make the money. Pastor hearing you, know, but I don't make it happen. I had to look fit. Will you be one of those that will hear well done? Or will you be one of those who hear depart from me? I want to encourage us. Make an investment
because your investment in the kingdom of God, that is what will last for all eternity. And I heard a message recently, I heard a spoken word some time back, and I like how the young person put it. In that spoken word, the title of the spoken word was HIV positive, heaven in view. I'm concluding here. Heaven in view. Brothers and sisters, make sure that you live your life HIV positive, heaven in view. Because as I said, we are pilgrims and we will not be here forever. So this is one time when the acid test is done, Brother James, make sure you're HIV positive. Yeah, I'm very serious in my song Humorous. Make sure you keep heaven in view. HIV. This is one time that when the roll is called up yonder, make sure you're HIV positive. Make sure it is well with my soul. Make sure that your name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Because as I said, based upon what we have received, based upon how we utilize our resources, our time, and our opportunity, and all of us, we have received something. There was a call, and we have received. And there is a day of reckoning, because why? The Master is returning. And there is a day of reward. Every man will be rewarded. Oh, what a day that will be. Keep the end in mind, brethren. Heaven in view. HIV. Keep heaven in view. In all that we do, in all your earthly sojourn, in all your conquests, in all your aspirations, in all that you aspire to do, make sure you keep heaven in view. Because at the end of the day, I don't know about you, I want to hear well done. I want to hear well done. I want you to bow your heads with me at this time. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you. We thank you. And there's a call. There's a call that is going out in this house this morning. There's a call. And if you all could permit me, I want to come down a little bit closer. There's a call. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, as we bow our heads, come on, let's just pray. Because I feel there is a call right here, even before we do anything else and pray for the family. A call. What kind of investment are you making with your life? Psalm 90, a psalm written by Moses. Moses is praying. He said unto man, is given 70 70 years. And if by reason of strength, he may live to be 80. Mr. Lambkin broke the record. 89. Thank God. Thank God for that. Young people in the house, you might be young today, you don't know if you might get older, no. Because when it comes to death, death is not racial, no. Death is not prejudicial. No. Death don't discriminate, death don't show favoritism. The rich will die, the poor will die, the king will die, the vagrant will die. Whether you're living in the hood, the ghetto, the slum, the suburb, the rural area, the posh area, playing field level. The Master is returning. A day of reckoning. A day of reward. Based upon what we have received. And as we bow our heads and we close our eyes, before we even pray for the family, Could somebody afford me the opportunity to pray with them? You're here this morning and you have never surrendered your life to Jesus. You are not born again. And to yourself be true. To yourself be true. Pastor, I've been thinking about it. And maybe you keep saying someday. Someday. Someday, preacher, I will give my life to Jesus. Someday. You see, the thing about that someday is not a day of the week. Eh? The Bible says now is the day of salvation. Now is the acceptable time. Now, now. Today, if you shall hear his voice, harden not your heart. Now. There is an urgency about salvation. Today is the day of salvation, not tomorrow, not when you stop this, not when you clean up your life. Come like the prodigal son. He's coming back from a pig pen. He's messed up. He's not coming back from Hayatin. But thank God that Father has his arms wide open. And this morning, our Father, his arms are wide open. Who will say, Pastor, pray for me. I want to be born again. I want to give my life to Jesus. I want to repent. Repent, believe, and commit RBC. Repent, turn from sin, believe, accept as truth, and commit my life to Jesus. As we bow heads and close our eyes, if that is your desire this morning, I'm standing right here. And I want to pray with you and I want to pray for you. I want to lead you in a prayer of repentance. And if that is your desire, could you just shoot your hand up in the air and I want to pray for you. Do we have one person in this house? I want to be born again. I want to commit my life to Jesus.
Praise.
Do we have anybody? Do we have one person in this house? This is, thank you, my brother. Thank you. I see one hand. Do we have, come, my brother, come. Come and join me. Come and stand with me. Yeah. The Bible says there is rejoicing in heaven over one sinner that repents. But I feel there is somebody else. Could we just break the music? Break the music. Could you know, singing at this time? Yes, let him come. But I feel there is somebody else. 10. This is Kong Dong. 9. You're here this morning, you're here and you know the Spirit of God is talking to you. This is not religious talking, this is about your soul and you only have one. You cannot play Russian roulette with your soul, you know. You lose it, you cannot retrieve it. It's not about pick two, you know. It's one. I'm going back to 10. Leave where you are and come and stand with our brother here. 9. The Ark of Mercy is still open, but one day it will be closed. 8. Do we have a second person? 7. You are not born again. If Jesus Christ should return before we say amen, and I turn over this mic, you don't know where you will spend your eternity. This is how crucial it is. 6. Will you hear well done, or will you hear depart from me? 5. Come, I'm waiting here for you, brother. I'm not taking my time with this. You know why? Because I want when you leave here and you stand before the judge of the whole earth, you will have no excuse. Everything that I pray and I talk in here about you, if you fail to make Jesus the Lord of your life, you see this message will haunt you for all eternity. You will remember every track you tore up and throw in the dustbin. It will haunt you. 4. Do we have a second person who will say, pray for me. I want to give my life to Jesus. If you want to see Mr. Sidney again, make sure you give your life to Jesus. 3. Do we have a second person who will say, pray for me. I want to give my life to Christ.
Two.
We have one more person. One. Yeah. The Holy Ghost is in this house, and there's a spirit of conviction right here in this house. Please don't walk away. Don't walk away from Jesus. I'm going back to five. I'm going back to five. Five. Don't walk away. This might just be the last call for somebody. Four. Set them free, God. Three. Two. One. Brother, you are making the greatest decision for all eternity. And I don't want you to stand here and feel no way. See what you're doing here, brother? At the age of 18, I will never forget that day. In the bomb shelter in Shagamas Youth Camp. I did just what you are doing here today. I sat there in the bomb shelter in the service. I went up in the service with my short pants. I really went up to get them off my back here because they always invited me to the service. And I had an encounter with Jesus. And I want to say it's more than 40 years now. And I thank God that Jesus touched my life. And whether you see, for me, it's Jesus for life, you know. And I don't want you to feel away. This is the greatest decision. Hear what the Bible says. This is not what the church says. This is what the Bible says. The Bible says all of us have sinned and come short of the glory of God. So I'm not here to bring condemnation. Nobody. But we thank God for grace, for the amazing grace. And I keep saying, if it's one song we could always sing every day, this is one song that will never get stale in the church. Amazing grace. How sweet the song that saved a wretch like me. The scripture said, if thou shalt confess with thy mouth and believe in thy heart that God gave Jesus, he died for your sins and he was buried, and he rose again on the third day, thou shalt be saved. For as many as received him, that is what salvation is about, receiving Jesus Christ. He died in your place. He paid the price for you. That is what redemption is all about. You cannot save yourself, but a price was paid. Thank God, salvation is free, but salvation is not cheap. An awesome price. If thou shalt confess, hear me, confess with thy mouth and believe in thy heart. You're not confessing to me, confessing to God. The Bible says all of us have sinned and come short of the glory of God. But if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. This is what the Bible says. He is faithful and just. Let me put it in the vernacular of the young people. Our God dealing with you straight up, brother. God is not setting you up. Revelation 3, verse 20, behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man shall hear my voice and open the door, he's going to come in. You are here to invite Jesus in your heart. He that had the Son had life. He that had not the Son had not life. And I want to make it very clear to you what you're about to do. And this is the greatest decision you will ever make. And I'm not saying you may not stumble and fall. You feel for the 40 years I didn't stumble and mess up. But thank God for grace. Somebody say grace. Grace. Yeah. It's grace. It's grace. Grace. And I feel we could just take a little praise break right here. Lord, I thank you for grace and mercy. Hey, thank you for your grace and your mercy. You have not dealt with us according to our sins, but grace and mercy. Come on, somebody, just give him praise. Thank God for grace and mercy. Your goodness, oh God, keep pursuing me. Hallelujah. There is no mountain you wouldn't climb up, no wall you wouldn't kick down. Coming after me. We bless your name. Brother, I just want you to lift your right hand, and I want you to say this prayer with me. God, Father, we thank you. We thank you. Congregation, join with our brother. What's your name, brother? Junior. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Look, when we join him in Junior in this prayer of repentance, Junior, but let this prayer be your desire. Let this prayer be your desire, your personal desire. I'm just assisting you. Say it together with us. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, I come to you. I am a sinner and I cannot save myself. But I believe your word that Jesus died for my sins and rose again on the third day. Come into my heart, Jesus. Wash me in your blood. Cleanse me from all unrighteousness. And with your grace and with your strength, I will serve you for the rest of my life. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for sending Jesus to die for me. Hallelujah. We want to pray for our brother. Come on, Deacon Duke. Could you join me here? Come. We have some of the men. Come on. I want to ask some of the men. Come and stand behind this brother. Come and stand behind. Here, come, Brother Rolston. Come on. Yeah, we standing with him. Yeah, I want about two other men. Two other men. Come and stand with him. Hallelujah. Yeah, we standing with him. Hallelujah. Yeah, Brother Jack, come and stand with him. Come on, I want you to raise your hand and put him. Come on, this brother is like Lazarus. Hallelujah. Yeah, this stone has been removed, but somebody need to take off the grave clothes. Lord, we pray for him. Yes, brethren, cry out for him. We untangle him. We untangle him from the grave clothes. We lose his feet. We lose his head, his eyes, to see right, to walk right, to talk right. We untangle him from the grave clothes. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Oh God, every generational curse, every hereditary spirit that is contrary to the will of God, we call him out. We say, Junior, come out from darkness into the marvelous light. Holy Spirit, bear witness with his spirit that there is a new day written down in glory. We call forth the preacher. We call forth a mighty man of God. In the name of Jesus, touch him, strip him, purge Junior this morning, God. And fill him with your spirit this morning, oh God. Fill him up, God. Fill him up, God. In the name of Jesus, we thank you. We thank you, God. Yeah. Yes. Yes, Jesus, cover him, cleanse him, purge him. Hey, God. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. We want to make sure we get your name. Somebody please get, take his name, take his address, take his cell phone number, because we want to keep in contact with him. Amen. God bless you. The Bible said there is rejoicing in heaven over one sinner that repent. So there is a big fete in heaven as a result of you, you know, Junior. The angels rejoicing. Hallelujah. Come on, everybody. Before we pray for the family, I want everybody to stand with me. Come on, 2 more minutes. And come on, let us lift our voices and give God praise. I want you to open your mouth and give him praise. Father, we bless your name this morning. Father, we give you glory and praise. We rejoice. Oh God, we sing the song. There is a new name written down in glory. And it's mine, and it's mine, and it's mine. Thank you, Lord, for your amazing grace. Thank you for your steadfast love. The songwriter says, the steadfast love of the Lord, it never ceases. His mercies never comes to an end. They are what? New every morning. New every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness, God. We bless your name. We bless your name. Hallelujah. I want to ask the family, could you just join me in front here? Could the family please join me in front here? Hallelujah. The rest of the congregation, you could have your seat, and the family just stand in front here. Just, hallelujah. Come on, and I just want you to hold hands. Family, grandchildren, children. Ah, God. Jesus, Father, we thank you. We thank you, Lord. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hey, yeah, yeah, Simeon boy, in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. We bless your name. We bless the name. Come on, family. I want you to hold hands. Hold hands, family. Hallelujah. Grab hold of the person's hands. Hallelujah. Yeah, yes, Lord. We bless your name. We worship. We give you praise. Ah, God, Father, we thank you. We thank you. Hallelujah. Sister Duke, come, Sister Duke. Come down here and join me here. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Lord, we thank you. We thank you, Lord. Yeah, yeah. I feel that they have some walls. There are some walls that has to be broken down this morning here. Lord, break the walls down. Every Jericho wall. In the name of Jesus. Mash up. Mash up. Something have to be broken here. Yeah, I know we're in a funeral service, but this is a funeral deliverance service this morning, God. Oh, God, break down the walls. Jericho must fall. Somebody need to come out. The snare of the fowler is broken. Faustin, the snare of the fowler, the snare of the fowler, Lambkin family, the fear of the fowler, break down the snare, the trap of the fowler. Somebody need to escape, escape, escape the snare of the fowler, God. Break down every stronghold. Break it down, God. Sister Cathy,
hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh God, Father, today we give you praise, we give you praise, we give you praise. Oh God, Father, we thank you again for your goodness and your mercies. Oh, we thank you, God, for your love. Oh God, we thank you, oh God, because you are God. Oh God, you sit high and look low and you see and you know all things this morning, Father. And oh God, we bring, oh God, this family before you. Oh God, in the name of Jesus, you know each and everyone here by name and number. Oh God, you know their thoughts. Oh God, you know. Oh God, you know. Oh God, you know them individually, oh God. And Father, we lift them up before you in the name of Jesus. Oh God, we pray, oh God, that you're gonna bind them together, oh God, as cords that cannot be broken. Father, bind them together, oh God, in the name of Jesus. We come again against every plan and every plot, oh God, of the enemy. Oh God, we know his purpose is to steal and to kill and to destroy and to confuse and to mash up and to separate. But oh God, you said in your word, you came that they will have life and have it more abundantly. So we speak abundant life today, oh God, in this family, oh God, the children, the grandchildren, the great-grand. Oh, in the name of Jesus, God, your word say, God, that you will extend your salvation, oh God, to your children, to Mr. Lambkin children, and his children, children, and his children, children, children. So God, we speak it into being. We speak salvation. We speak deliverance. We speak healing. Healing of the mind, healing of the heart, healing in the spirit. Oh God, we pray salvation will come upon them in the name of Jesus. Oh God, we come against every spirit of confusion and bacchanal, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Because God, we know, we see it, oh God, where there's a debt, oh God, there's always some kind of pull and tug. But God, we come against that spirit in the name of Jesus, and we pray for oneness of mind. We pray for unity. We pray for love. We pray a peace. Oh God, they're gonna cover them with your blood. Oh God, cover them with your blood in their going out and in their coming in. Oh God, be a fence around them this morning. Give your angels charge over them in the name of Jesus. Oh God, in the name of Jesus, strengthen them. Oh God, strengthen Mary, strengthen Tony. Oh God, the Fustins, oh God, in the name of Jesus, we speak life and we come against every stronghold. We come against every generational curse and sickness in the name of Jesus. And God, we thank you today. We thank you for all that you have done and all that you are doing and all that you are about to do, oh God, in the midst of this family. Oh God, and we give you praise and we give you thanks. Can somebody say praise the Lord? Can somebody give God some praise? Can somebody give God a clap offering and say thank you, Jesus? We thank you, God. We praise you. We worship you. We magnify your name, God, because great is your name and greatly to be praised. In Jesus' name, amen.
Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. You may return to your seats at this time. We will be doing the committal up at the cemetery. So at this time, we want to just open the coffin and we could have the viewing of the body. The committal will be done at the Tunapuna Cemetery. So we're asking that as you come, they will have a smooth flow. Just walk along as you have the final viewing of the remains of our brother. I call the worship leaders to sing a song for us. As
praise
hallelujah.
Goodbye, world.
You're free to come and have a view.
I stay no longer with you. Goodbye, pleasures of sin. I stay no longer with you. I made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. I made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. So goodbye, world. I stay no longer with you. Goodbye, pleasures of sin. I stay no longer with you. I made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. I made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. Oh, goodbye, world. I stay no longer with you. Goodbye, pleasures of sin. I stay no longer with you. I made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. I made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. Born, born, born again. Thank God I'm born again. Born, born, born again. Thank God I'm born again. Born of the water, spirit and the blood. Thank God I'm born again. Born of the water, spirit and the blood. Thank God I'm born again. Born, born, born again. Thank God I'm born again. Born, born, born again. Thank God I'm born again. So goodbye, world. I stay no longer with you. Goodbye, pleasures of sin. I stay no longer with you. I made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. I made up my mind go God's way the rest of my life. So goodbye, world. I stay no longer with you. Goodbye, pleasures of sin. I stay no longer with you. I made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. I made up my mind. Go God's way the rest of my life. Goodbye, world. I stay no longer with you. Goodbye, pleasures of sin. I stay no longer with you. I made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. I made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. Free, free, free. I have been set free. I have met the man of Galilee. He took away my load, my heavy load of sin.
glory, hallelujah.
Thank God I'm free, free, free.
I have been set free. I have met the man of Galilee. He took away my load, my heavy load of sin. And now I'm shouting glory, hallelujah.
Thank God I'm free, free, free.
I have been set free. I have met the man of Galilee. He took away my load, my heavy load of sin. And now I'm shouting glory, hallelujah. I'm free, I'm being the same again, oh Lord. I'll never be the same again, no, no. Since my life has changed, I am not the same, and I'll never be the same again. I'll never be the same again, no, no. Never be the same again, no, no,
no, no, no.
Oh, since my life has changed, I am not the same. I'll never be the same again. So goodbye, world. I'll stay no longer with you. Goodbye, pleasures of sin. I'll stay no longer with you. I've made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. I've made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. Yeah, goodbye, world. I'll stay no longer with you. Goodbye, pleasures of sin. I'll stay no longer with you. I've made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. I've made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. I've made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. I made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. I made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. I made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my
imagine just standing before the king. To be surrounded by your glory. Imagine just standing before the King.
With my